Italian football lover channel, my friends. Inter won 2-1 against Milan, Coppa Italia, and I want to talk about the tactics and analysis of this game. First, I want to start with Inter tactics. I want the Inter's player names and numbers of Milan players. Inter played in classic Antonio Conte's formation 3-5-2. In Inter, Brozovic played close to defense line. He played more defensively, and Barella and Arturo Vidal participated to Inter attacks more, and sometimes De Vrij came close to right, and Brozovic came back to center of the defense, got the balls, and he started the attacks and delivered the balls to his teammates. And at the same time, Brozovic played close to 1-1 against Brahim Diaz on the midfield. And Milan developed attacks from the wings with Darmian and Perisic, sometimes brought the balls to the forward. And when Darmian came from the right, and Arturo Vidal got into the penalty area of Milan, and Perisic came into the Milan box, and he came to back post to head shot with Arturo Vidal. And Barella came close to Darmian. He supported Darmian. He came close to left in Milan attacks. And at the same time, sometimes Romelu Lukaku came back to midfield and got the ball. Sometimes he came close to right. And at the same time, Sanchez was so effective. Inter progressed attacks more from the right. And sometimes at the same time, Sanchez came to right and forced the left wing back of AC Milan, and Inter played effectively, but Milan found the goal with Zlatan Ibrahimovic, and Milan was 1-0 ahead in the first half. At the same time, in Milan, Lukaku played 1-1 against Romagnoli, and Sanchez played 1-1 against Kjaer, but after Kjaer was injured and new transfer, a young player Tomori replaced of him. And on the midfield, there were so many bilateral struggles between Barella and Kessié. At the same time, Vidal played 1-1 against Meite. The first half was finished 1-0. Inter started the second half with a substitution, and Darmian out, Hakimi in. Hakimi played on the right like this. In the second half, Hakimi came to forward. He brought the balls to the forward, and Inter generally progressed attacks from the right with Hakimi. And at the same time, Barella and Alexis Sanchez every time came close to right, and they forced the left back of AC Milan. And at the same time, one more substitution made by Antonio Conte. Perisic out, Alex Lautaro Martinez'in. After this substitution, Kolarov started to play on the left of the midfield, and Lautaro Martinez played on the left forward with Lukaku. Lautaro played on the left forward here, and Sanchez played behind of Lukaku and Lautaro here like this. And Inter had the ball, and every time Inter developed attacks, made pressure on Milan, and Milan played with 10 players because Zlatan Ibrahimovic saw red card in the 60 minutes of the game. And but Brozovic started to play left of the defense instead of Kolarov. Brozovic came to left, but after Conte made two more substitutions in Inter, Kolarov out, Ashley Young in. Young played on the left, and Brozovic out, Eriksen in. Eriksen played on the midfield. He played offensively, and Eriksen scored a goal from the free kick. It was so good. Eriksen came back to Inter this free kick goal. He was the hero of the game. Inter won 2-1 this game. Secondly, I want to talk about Milan tactics. Milan played in classic formation 4-2-3-1. In Milan, Kessié played more defensively and close to defense line, and Mate played more offensively. He came close to forward and supported the attacks. At the same time, in Milan attacks, Theo Hernandez and Dalot came to forward and supported the attacks together. When Theo Hernandez came to forward, Kessié came to left back, and sometimes Romagnoli came to left, Kjaer came to right, and Kessié came back to center of the defense and got the balls delivered to his teammates. And in Milan, Kjaer was injured in the first half, and new young transfer Tomori replaced of Kjaer, and he played on the center of the defense. And in Milan, Selemakers made press on Kolarov on the forward, and Zlatan Ibrahimovic played 1-1 against Stefan De Vrij, and Leao made press on Skriniar. And on the midfield, Brahim Diaz played close to Brozovic on the midfield, and every time Kessié played against Barella, and there were so many bilateral struggles between Kessié and Nicolò Barella on the midfield, and Mate made press on, played close to Arturo Vidal on the midfield. And in the first half, Milan found the goal with Zlatan Ibrahimovic, and Mate came to forward and lowered the ball front of Zlatan, and from here Zlatan's shot scored the goal. The Milan was 1-0 ahead with this goal. In the second half, Ibrahimovic saw red card for Milan, and Milan played the game on their own half pitch in the second half. Milan had to play defensively because Milan played with 10 players against strong opponent Inter. And Stefano Pioli made some substitutions in the second half. First substitution for Inter, Brahim Diaz out on the midfield, and Ante Rebic in. After this substitution, Ante Rebic played on the left here, and Leao played on the central forward. But after Stefano Pioli made last two substitution, and Selemakers out, Castillejo in, at the same time Leao out, Krunic in, after these substitutions, Milan played in 4-4-1 formation. Krunic played on the left of the midfield, and Ante Rebic played on the forward, lonely here, Rebic, and Castillejo played on the right of the midfield. But it was so hard to play against Inter with 10 players, and Inter found the goal in the last minutes of the game with Christian Eriksen from free kick. And Milan lost this game 2-1. Milan is looking for Hakan Çalhanoğlu, couldn't play because of coronavirus. He is so important player for Milan. And all my comments like this, all my analyses like this. You can subscribe to my channel, watch my videos. Please open up your notification links, notification bells. You can write your suggestions and comments under my video. And thank you very much. See you on my next videos. Bye.